Hello, welcome. My name is Whitaker Strain. I'm a second generation oyster farmer here. We are on the shores of beautiful Tomales Bay, where we've been farming oysters since 1985. We operate three leases on the bay for a total of 90 acres, and we grow five species of oysters as well as clams and mussels here. And this beachfront location is where we do most of our processing. And so prior to our farming operation here, we nursery our oysters in our nursery in Spat Point Marina in Bodega Bay. That's where the oysters begin their life cycle. And we'll raise them up in our nursery there for about 6 months prior to being deployed on the bay here, which gets them up to about a half inch in size.
A combination of ballast and water pump draws seawater up through each upweller, which spills into the central trough. As water is drawn up through each chamber, the oyster spat is fluidized, which allows for greater loading densities of the oysters.
Juvenile stage is a very critical stage for the oyster, and we found that once we get them over that hump, so to speak, they'll do much better in their survival rates out in the bay after they've gone through that nursery system.
Water flow in a FLUPSY promotes accelerated oyster spat growth by increasing food algae availability, dissolved oxygen levels, and waste product removal. Other benefits include protection from weather and predation.
I took the folks here on a tour of our South Bay lease, which is about 15 to 20 acres, where we do most of our floating cultures. So, you know, floating bags on floating lines. We put about 250 oysters in each bag, and when they stay on the surface, they get that tumbled action that shellfish lovers like.
Wow, there's a whole lot of moon jellies in Tomales Bay.
We do a couple different methods of oyster culture, including some of our floating lines. We also do ground lines and rack and bag. And the different culture methods offer different, different benefits. So we try to do a bit of each, but essentially our job here on the bay is to be good stewards of the environment. And so, you know, we do that by monitoring the areas in which we farm, looking out for species, some species such as eelgrass, among others. You know, reporting and sharing our findings with the various management agencies as well as the scientists that we like to partner with.
For UC Davis Aquaculture, this is Dr. Jackson Gross.